Good morning, everyone. I'm Meenakshi, student of SHPT School of Library Science. I'm going to discuss about the types of libraries, their role, functions, and services. As we know that libraries serve the society because they know that there are different kinds of users and therefore different user needs. According to definition, a library is a place where the information is collected, processed, stored, and disseminated to the users according to their needs at the time and place required by them. Now we will discuss about the types of libraries, which is divided into four major categories: national library, academic library, special or research or business library, and public library. First of all, we will see the national library. A library designated as such by appropriate national body and funded by the national government is known as national library. It serves to the nation as a whole and are copyright libraries. The examples of the National Library are National Library of India and the British Library. This is the National Library of India situated in Kolkata. The aim is to serve as a permanent depository for all publications issued in the country. Now, we will discuss about the role of the National Library. The first role is the National Repository. A National Library should serve as a national repository of manuscripts, books, periodicals, motion pictures, microfilms, sound recordings, videotapes, disc audio and video, maps, printed photographs, etc. Materials on the country. National Library collects all the printed material on the country, no matter where this is published. It should try to get a microfilm or a photocopy of all those unique documents on the nation available outside the country. Bibliographical and documentation services. National libraries, with the Delivery of Books and Newspaper Act, have control over the literary output of a country. Thus, it is convenient for a national library to publish a national bibliography as a referral center. National Library should collect bibliographies and catalogs issued by various institutions in the country. Suppose if a particular material is not available in the library, then the librarian can give the reference of a particular library to the users. Preservation and conservation. National libraries should have laboratories for preservation and conservation of documents, conduct research in this area, and provide necessary training to other libraries in the country. Other roles. National libraries should serve only as reference and referral center. They should not undertake lending, but the reprographic service should be provided. Now we will see the functions of the National Library. To acquire and maintain documents about the country or its people or activities published outside the country. Second is to collect and preserve selected manuscript and other such archival records of national relevance and importance. Third is to collect and preserve specialized material books for the blind, dramatic, compositions, etc. To serve as a central and comprehensive collection of national output acquired through the legal deposit, gifts, or exchange. To disseminate catalog in printed and non-printed, also like microforms and machine-readable forms. Now we will see the services of the National Library. The first service is the Interlibrary Lending Service. It is everywhere on the basis of the interlibrary loan. If any book or document is not available in the library, then that book or document can be borrowed from the other libraries. To offer reference, bibliographic, which includes database services, and should be provided to the users for their access and information services. The third one is to provide facilities for reading resources or materials for consultation, etc. The fourth one is to provide a reprographic service. It is very essential service which should be provided to the users, which includes photocopying and microfilms. The one of the service of the National Library is to serve as a referral center. Now we will discuss about the academic libraries. According to definition, the specialized library on educational needs are known as academic libraries. It includes school, college and university library. The example of the academic library is the SNDT Women's University Library in the Churchgate campus. The library is committed to empowerment of women by providing resources and services with ICTs that are essential to teaching, learning, research and creation of knowledge system. Now we will discuss about the role and functions of the academic libraries. First of all, we will see the role and functions of the school libraries. Acquiring, maintaining, lending and keeping track of books and other documents which are relevant to the needs and interests of the teachers and students. Generating curiosity and interest among teachers and students. Engendering strong self-learning ability and skills for lifelong learning. The next one is enabling the teachers to use learning resources to support various programs. Now we will discuss about the role and functions of the college libraries. To provide latest collective of textbooks, course-related material, and journals on print and electronic media. To maintain good collection of reference books, magazines, newspapers, etc. To train the students in the use of library cataloging, reference sources, net-based information access, etc. The next one is to provide career guidance to the students and make them useful citizens of the society. To offer variety of services which includes newspaper clipping, bibliographies, access to database, etc. Now we will discuss about the role and functions of the university library. To provide necessary resources for research in the field of interest to university. To help the university faculty in keeping abreast of development in their disciplines. The next is to provide library facilities for the success of the formal instructional programs. The another is to bring books, students, scholars together under the condition that encourage reading for pleasure, self-discovery, personal growth and sharpening of the intellectual curiosity. Now we will discuss about the services of the academic library. First of all, we will see the services of the school libraries. Reference service to the users at request. The libraries should provide the reference service to the users at their request. Story hour services should be provided in the libraries so that the teachers who are involved in these have to tell them the story, for which the libraries have to provide some facilities to undertake their things. Display of press and other clipping of services should be provided by the libraries for primary and middle students. Video shows both for entertainment and learning on various themes as a service provided by the school libraries. The next is book display and exhibition on important occasion, through which they have to select the books on their own choice according to their taste. Now we will discuss about the services of the college and university libraries. The services of the college and university libraries are user orientation, education and information literacy. User orientation means the orientation of the resources which are made available to the users. Tell them how to use the resources and how to replace the resources. Assistance in the location of documents or use of library catalog or understanding of reference books, etc. The next one is the provision of general and specific information. Reservation of document is also one of the services which is provided by both university and college libraries. Reprographic service is another service. Reference reader's advisory service is one of the services given by the college libraries. Lending and interlibrary loan service means if the particular document is not available in the library, then the library can borrow that document from the other library. Now we will discuss about the special libraries. The special libraries are also known as research or business libraries. According to definition, a special library is neither academic, commercial, national, or public, but it intends to serve the needs of a portion of a community requiring detailed information on a limited subject field. For example, TIFR Library. This is the TIFR Library, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. Now we will discuss about the role and function of the special library. The role and function of the special libraries are selection of documents and sources of information. The next one is the acquisition of documents and data. The next one is the processing of document and data. The fourth one is the storage of document and data, retrieval of document and data, and the last one is the publication or reproduction of document and data. Now we will discuss about the services of the special libraries. The services of the special libraries includes issue of documents. A user may request for an article from a periodical. Then the library may provide the issue of the periodical containing an article or a copy of the same using a method of reproduction. The next service is routing of periodicals. It is an important means of dissemination of information. In special libraries, very often the bound volumes of periodicals are circulated, but the current issues are routed. The third one is the interlibrary loan. In case a particular book or a periodical or some other document required for reference which is not in the library, then an effort is made to locate the same in another library. The request for a document not in the library is referred to as an interlibrary loan. The next one is the retrospective search. Retrospective search is concerned with provision of answers to specific inquiries requiring verification of facts or references, literature search, and compilation of bibliographies or documentation list. The next one is selective dissemination of information, SDI service. It is an advanced kind of service directed towards the individual so as to cater to individual requirements. This is highly personalized service. It consists in matching of information with the interest of the users. It enables the librarian to obtain feedback on the value of the service. Referral service. The reference staff attempts to bring users in contact with documents likely to contain required information. They can tell about the names, addresses, telephone number, and brief description of the persons and institution who can provide information to the users. This service is known as referral service. The next service is the translation service, which is also provided by the special library. The librarian provides the translation of the abstract or summary, or arrange a meeting between user and one who knows the language. Bibliographic instruction. It is a systematic approach to teach the user as to how to use the library profitably. This is also one of the services provided by the special libraries. The next service is the reprographic service, which is very important service and is provided by the special libraries. Now we will discuss about the public library. First of all, we will see the definition of the public libraries. The libraries, which being the local gateway to knowledge, provides a basic condition for lifelong learning, independent decision-making, and cultural development of individual and social groups are known as public libraries. For example, Delhi Public Library. It is the local center for information, making all kinds of information and knowledge readily and freely available to its users. The second example is the State Central Library. This is the State Central Library. Now we will discuss about the role and functions of the public library. The role and functions of the public library includes to create and strengthen reading skills and habits in children from an early age. The next one is to provide opportunities for personal creative development. To stimulate the imagination and creativity of children and young people. To promote awareness of cultural heritage, appreciation of arts, scientific achievement, and innovation. The next one is to provide access to all performing arts is the objective and function of the public libraries. To ensure access to citizens of all sorts of community information. Now we will discuss about the services of the public libraries. The services of the public libraries includes the following: issue of documents. The public library provides the service of the issue of the documents. This means a user can issue a particular document in the public library. The next service is the interlibrary loan. The public library provides an interlibrary loan service. In case a book or a periodical or some other document required for study or reference is not in the library, then it may have to be procured on the interlibrary loan. Provision of general and specific information. Provision of general and specific information is a service provided by the public library. The provision of general and information includes where are the texts, how can I become a member of the library, etc. Provision of the specific information would require the use of documents available in the library or consultation of another colleagues or another library. Assistance in searching or location of documents or use of library catalog or understanding of books. The assistance in searching or locating of documents or use of library catalog is also one of the services provided by the public library. The next service is the Reader's Advisory Service. It is concerned with providing reading guidance to individual in the selection of document for study. It is also one of the services provided by the public library. Compilation of bibliographies. Bibliographies may be compiled on demand or in anticipation. This is a useful service. Bibliographies can be helpful in providing readers advisory service. Referral service. A reference section should provide current information on service made available by the local bodies. It should also maintain a list of individual and organization from whom a user can get the information. The latter may be referred to as referral services. Library orientation and bibliographic instruction. The library orientation and bibliographic instruction is also one of the services which is provided by the public libraries. So we have discussed about the types of libraries, their role, functions and services. And we have found that the role, functions, services and collection of the libraries depends upon the types of libraries.